Philippine lawmakers convened a special joint session on Saturday for the speech of Japanese Prime Minister Kishida. There, the Prime Minister vowed to defend the rule of law, which he says is facing serious threats. RG Cruz has tonight's top story.
Congress got back to work a few days earlier than scheduled to convene a joint session to listen to a speech by visiting Japanese Prime Minister Kishida Fumio. While lawmakers would only assemble on this scale to hear the president's annual report to the nation, on Saturday they got the lowdown on the current global situation from a world leader.
Ladies and gentlemen, the international community is currently at a historic turning point, and the international order, based on the rule of law that we have taken for granted, is under serious threat.
But the Prime Minister assured lawmakers that the cooperation of Japan, the Philippines, and the United States to ensure rule of law continues over force. The PM said part of his plan for a free and open Indo-Pacific is the defense of the rule of law at all costs.
Underlying this plan is our determination to lead the international community toward cooperation rather than division and confrontation, and to defend freedom and the rule of law at all costs.
His plan includes a Japanese grant of 12 ships to strengthen the Coast Guard, radar to boost the Air Force's defense of the Philippine airspace, and coastal surveillance radar to the Navy under the official security assistance. Kishida also announced the start of formal negotiations for a reciprocal access agreement between the Philippines and Japan to facilitate joint trainings between Japanese and Philippine forces in both countries.
Japan will continue to contribute to the enhancement of the Philippine security capabilities, thereby contributing to regional peace and stability.
There's also the grant of heavy equipment for disasters in Mindanao and the continued support of Japan for the administration's infrastructure program.
We will continue to support economic and social development in line with President Marcos' Build Better More program.
Congressional leaders hailed the speech. Prime Minister Kishida is the sixth world leader and the first Japanese leader to address a joint session of the Philippine Congress. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
Some Philippine lawmakers expressed concern over a proposed security agreement that will see Japanese troops holding military drills with Filipino soldiers, similar to the visiting forces agreement with the United States. Vivian Gulia reports.
Leaders of both chambers of Congress thanked Japan for its support to bolster the Philippines' defense capabilities amid escalated tension in the West Philippine Sea.
With reverence and hope for our shared future, today's discourse fortifies the bridge between our great nations.
He and Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri also backed the proposed reciprocal access agreement between the two countries. The deal is similar to the visiting forces agreement between the Philippines and the United States and the status of visiting forces agreement between the Philippines and Australia.
Kami naman sa Senado, handa po kami na talakayin itong RAA kasi kami po ang mag-ratify niyan at nakakuha na po ako ng majority.
But some minority lawmakers raised concerns over the proposed military agreement with Japan. House Deputy Minority Leader Franz Castro cited the possibility that it can lead to human rights violation and abuse of Filipino women. Gabriela Partilist Representative Arlene Brosas adds, history would reflect the abuses committed by Japanese soldiers against comfort women during the Second World War. The House Speaker and the Senate President sought to allay fellow lawmakers' concerns.
Yung mga karanasan ng nakaraan, siyempre natuto na rin tayo.
Meron naman tayo mga guidelines dito sa RAA na hindi po nila pwedeng abusuhin. That is to follow the rule of law in the Philippines.
Progressive groups staged a rally outside the House of Representatives to oppose the RAA, which they say may further escalate tensions in the West Philippine Sea. Senator Risa Ontiveros says, should the deal require Senate's ratification, they will scrutinize it.
Kung maayos ang agreement na iyan, makakadagdag lang siya sa konkretong, hindi lang bilateral but multilateral defense and security arrangements na magandang magkaroon ng ating bansa with like-minded nations na gustong mag-uphold ng rule of law at sea.
Apart from Japanese aid, the leaders of the 19th Congress assured the public they will also allocate funding to boost the capabilities of the country's Coast Guard and Armed Forces. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.
Now still on Kishida's visit, the Prime Minister also toured a Japanese-funded transport project in Valenzuela City. This is just one of the many major infrastructure projects fueled by Japanese aid. Michael DeLizo reports.
Well, Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida on Saturday visited the Metro Manila Subway Project Depot in Valenzuela City. Civil works are ongoing for the 33-kilometer underground railway system. The project is expected to cost 355.6 billion pesos, mostly covered by a loan provided by the Japan International Cooperation Agency, or JICA. Japan has increased engagement with the Philippines since the time of late President Benigno Aquino III, as Tokyo and Manila faced separate maritime disputes with Beijing. Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista assured Kishida that progress of development is on track for completion. About 9 Philippine big-ticket transport projects will be delivered on the back of 1.315 trillion yen worth of Japanese aid, including 2 projects, each in both the aviation and maritime sectors, and 5 railways.
The track record of Japanese commitments to investments, right, trade, and so on is unparalleled. If they say we're going to invest, we're going to support. Mm-hmm.
Kishida concluded his two-day state visit in Manila with a meeting at the Philippine Coast Guard. Kishida said Japan agreed to provide the Philippines coastal surveillance radars under its official security assistance program aimed at improving the Philippine Navy's maritime domain awareness capabilities. Kishida said the relationship between the Philippines and Japan has reached the point of a golden age, with cooperation between the two nations continuing to deepen in recent years.
Japan and the Philippines tourism sectors also getting a boost. The two countries signed a Memorandum of Cooperation for Tourism, their first standalone cooperation agreement. Under this deal, both countries agreed to increase tourist arrivals as well as exchange information on matters related to the industry. Tokyo is one of Manila's top sources of visitors, with nearly a quarter of a million Japanese arrivals into the Philippines each year. A joint working group from the two countries' tourism departments is also set to convene for the implementation of the deal, which will run for 5 years, subject to renewal. A Philippine analyst sees many positives in the visit of Prime Minister Kishida. For International Studies Professor Renato De Castro, the reciprocal access agreement being negotiated by both sides offer benefits for both parties. De Castro believes this kind of agreement could eventually be expanded to include Manila's other allies. He believes this kind of alliance offers many upside to the Philippines, since it can also boost cooperation in other areas, including economic, technological, and scientific partnerships.
They're not using the term status of force agreement, no? Reciprocal access agreement. So you will have greater presence of Japanese forces here. They will be conducting joint military exercises with the Philippines. Both sides, of course, will be gaining from conducting, of course, these joint military exercises. And I'm also looking at the prospect that this will not just be bilateral. Sooner rather than later, this might become a trilateral, even quadrilateral security relationship. Well, we will have, of course, the Philippines, Japan, the United States, making it trilateral.
More on Kishida's visit, maritime law expert UP Professor Jay Batombacal sees the deepening security ties between Manila and Tokyo as a significant step on the part of Japan. Batombacal explains Japan is historically reserved when it comes to military ties, but it agreed to a security arrangement with the Philippines. Batombacal also lauds the Marcos administration for seeking partnerships from non-traditional allies. He says Manila will also greatly benefit from this partnership, even if it earns the ire of China.
It's a great help to our defense capabilities because it allows us to source capabilities and assets from many different sources. We're not beholden to any one of them. And it also gives our armed forces the ability to pick and choose, essentially, what assets can be available and what we can essentially afford. No? Because after all, we're still a relatively small country. We're showing China that, no, you have to seriously talk with us if you really want a sincere adjustment and settlement of our respective interests. You have to treat us as equals. No? And if it takes forming partnerships and alliances with other countries for us to do that, then well and good.